That fateful day in September motivated young men and women to serve their country with a real sense of pride that rivaled the Cold War. They would soon find themselves in faraway places, driven by a new cause to defend their home. The story Marine Captain Jesse Melton was shared with us by his very proud mother and sister. Here again is Deborah Wiener.
This was Captain Jesse Melton III in action. But it was 2 days before the 7th anniversary of September 11th when the 29-year-old Marine from Brandelstown was killed in Operation Enduring Freedom.
Black Rain, Alpha 1.
He had a bad feeling about this combat tour in Afghanistan. He had already completed one tour in Iraq, as did his younger sister Janine, an Army captain.
I don't want to say that's why God chose him over me, but when I look at my brother's life and I look at the lives he's touched and I look at people as they sit back and they talk to me about the example that he led, officers and enlisted that served with him, beside him and under him, I think that his story is the best story to tell.
The story of Jesse Melton, seen here high-fiving curious Afghan children. Jesse Melton, a born leader, a man at a young age, 10 years old to be exact, when his father left home, leaving his mother with three children. Jesse, the oldest.
He said, Mom, I'm going to be the man of the house. And I said, Jesse, remember, no, I said, you're only 10. That's my responsibility. Don't worry about it. But Jesse would not be deterred by that. He was determined to look out for me and his siblings.
It was no surprise when Jesse joined the Marines his freshman year in college.
But I tell you, he was so well put together. He looked so handsome in his uniform. He was keeping things straight and clean. I said, oh my God, what? It was a transformation. When he put that uniform on, it was like a different person.
Jesse had just graduated from basic school in Quantico when 9/11 changed the world and his.
I said, Jesse, what does this mean? Does this mean that you guys are going to be involved in a conflict? He said, I don't know, Mom, I don't know, but I'm ready. But I'm ready. He was ready to do what needed to be done. He said, they can't come here and do that. You know, that's, no, he said, then I know something's going to have to be done.
First came a tour in Iraq for the communications officer, 1 year. When he returned home to Baltimore, Christmas was a true celebration. He even taught his mother how to dance the salsa. 3 years later, the call to serve came again. This time, it would be Afghanistan, Parwin province, training members of the Afghan National Army.
Did you ever think, raising your children here in Baltimore, that you would have a child in Afghanistan?
I never dreamed that I would have a child in Afghanistan. Never dreamed. You know, Iraq.
It was 6 months on the ground in Afghanistan before a roadside bomb exploded.
When they came here to the house and the gentleman said, we have some news for you. And I said, wait a minute, tell me that my son has just been wounded and that he wasn't killed. And he said, ma'am, I'm sorry to have to tell you that your son was killed. And I said, you know, the Lord giveth, the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Breath of God, we need a touch from you.
Jesse's funeral and homecoming service celebrated his life. A Marine's Marine, eulogized by his best friend.
He was my brother. And he'll always be. And I know that he's in a better place, but I really wish he were back.
4 days before he died, Jesse had told his mother to pray for him, pray that he would make it to his 30th birthday. He did not. But he let everyone know how he wanted to be remembered in a journal entry read by his sister Janine.
The one thing that I want people to be able to say about me is he was a wonderful human being and a fine Christian. That's the legacy I desire to leave behind, a legacy that I could take with me into eternity.
I believe totally that my son made a difference because, you know, he said he wanted to go change the world, and he did. The part of the world that he served in, he did.
Jesse Melton, a man of honor and integrity, a son and brother, loved and missed.
To date, 33 service members from Maryland have died in Afghanistan. We've lost more than 70 others fighting the war in Iraq. Tonight, we honor their sacrifice.